will never be the same.
Beloved, we're so excited to welcome you to another exciting week on The Voice of Resurrection. We are still dealing with this issue of consecration because our desire is that every one of us will enter into the realm where God is moved to show himself strong, to reveal his power, where the idols in our lives have been removed. So we want to continue to study it and discuss it because we are desperate for the glory to come back. We are desperate for God to bring deliverance in the lives of his people. The Bible declares that we should be as sons of God. You know, we are destined as signs and wonders to our generation. They shall marvel at the goodness of God in our lives, at the power of God in our lives. But generally, that's not what is seen because of compromises, disobedience, and all kinds of things that are happening in our lives and in this generation. May the Lord help you. I want to call your attention to this famous scripture, 2 Chronicles chapter 16, verse 9. For the eyes of the Lord run to and fro throughout the whole earth. So this is a global search for God. In every nation, every state, every county, every precinct, every village, every family, down to every man, his eyes are coursing to and fro throughout the whole earth. He's searching hearts. That's why every time you're consecrating to the Lord, don't let the devil deceive you. Don't let him fool you and tell you that you're wasting your time. For the eyes of the Lord is searching for you. He's searching for you. He's looking for a man anywhere, any place, whose heart, listen to it, for the eyes of the Lord run to and fro throughout the whole earth to show himself strong in the behalf of them, in the behalf of them whose heart is perfect toward him. Not those who are perfect in themselves, but those whose heart are perfect toward him. Hallelujah. Sometimes some of the things I celebrate don't even excite other people. One of the things that excite me, you know, because you go through so much, you fight battles, sometimes you make errors, and you just need reassurance from the Lord. And then he will send somebody bearing witness of their personal revelation from God concerning you. You see, and one day, one of my ministers said to me, you know, I was praying, and the Lord said to me, you need to follow your pastor. He is not perfect. But he says, but his heart is perfect towards me. Hey, I started celebrating. Because he said he will show himself strong on the behalf of them whose heart is perfect toward him. What does it mean for a man to have a perfect heart toward God? You love God. He is number one in your life and in your heart. No gimmickry. You're not serving him because you don't want to go to hell. He is really number one. You love him. Come on, watch this. You are concerned about his agenda in society and on the earth and across the board. A perfect heart. That's what David had. But David had errors, made errors. But his heart was perfect toward the Lord. David was a terrible parent. He didn't raise his children. But his heart was perfect toward the Lord. Is your heart perfect toward the Lord? Forget the intellectualizing of the matter. Forget the arguments. Can the Lord give such testimony concerning you? From an unsolicited source, particularly one that was struggling to obey as this minister was. And the Lord said to him, no, follow him, follow him. His heart is perfect toward me. He has his issues, he has his quirks, but his heart is perfect. Can God give that testimony? That's the need for your consecration, beloved. Do you want to see the power of God work for you? Do you want to see God bring deliverance in your life? Do you want God to tell angels about you? Do you want you to see demons submit themselves to you? Your enemies bow and fail because of the Lord your God. Then love him. Make him number one. Consecrate your heart towards him. Because he's moved by heart. Can you imagine this tower of strength, this inexhaustible supply of strength and power looking for expression? Like, wow, he said the heart is so hard to find one. That's perfect. So because heart is deceitful and desperately wicked above all things. He said, who can know it? But he said, but I, the Lord, search the heart. I try the reins to give every man according as his work shall be. So consecrating your heart, making sure that your heart remains pliable and tender before the Lord, even when you're frustrated, is key to everything. The blessing will continue to flow because your heart is like a farmer's land. You turn it over, you till it, and you remove things to plant. You have to keep your heart moist. You have to keep your heart broken, tilled in the presence of God, loving, worshiping, you know, even in pain, crying, but loving God in the process. A perfect heart. He said, you will cause his strength to get up and manifest. I'm prophesying to you. You asked God for an answer, so he gave it to me. This was in the scripture I was going to start with, and it just dropped. And as I'm sharing it, I know that you are watching. If you are the only one all over the earth, then it's enough that this devotional is getting done what God purposed for it. He wants to show himself strong on your behalf if your heart will get right. If your heart will, if you will consecrate yourself and consecrate your heart and remove the wedge and the things that are blocking our eyes from seeing and being able to get into what God has for us. May the Lord help you. May the Lord deliver you from your personal frustrations. And then remove the hindrances for his strength to come forth. Ah, thank you, Lord, for this word. Thank you for blessing this one you have chosen to hear this word. This word is specifically for you. Receive it in Jesus' name, and we love you. The rest of us listened in today, but it's for you. God bless you. We'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.